Sacramento Basketball Show. I'm your host, Scott Silva, and I'm here today on the campus of Sac State with the Sac State Hornet men's basketball team. How you guys doing today?
Good.
All right. Talk to me about Sac State basketball. You guys just introduce yourselves and the position you play and where you're from.
My name is Isaiah Medjipola Alpha, point guard, and I'm from New Zealand.
Joshua Penn, senior at the center.
My name is Jabizi Jacobs. I'm a forward senior, and I'm from Kane Country, California.
This group special?
You know, everybody really cares about each other. Everybody wants to work hard, and we're all just trying to reach the same goal, which would be winning the Big Sky Championship and going to the NCAA tournament. So everybody's just really willing to work hard for each other and to sacrifice for each other.
Okay. And you can see how many, like, returners we have. So it's like, it's not like trying to build a system. Like, we already had it, and like everybody, like he said, genuinely cares for each other. So it's just like a good whole dynamic for us.
To piggyback what she said, it's basically like a brotherhood. No, everyone cares about each other, everyone plays together, everyone plays hard, everyone plays for each other. So at the end of the day, like, we know when it gets hard, like, we're all good, because everyone's going to be good at the end of the day.
How close is this team compared to teams in the past that were here that you guys have played on?
You know, this group is just a really tight-knit group, so everybody's real close, like they were saying, brotherhood. We're just trying to build on what we've had in the past, trying to build on from last season, and just all trying to reach the same goal. So,
like, our coaches stress it too, like, we have, like, different activities and stuff that they try to incorporate all of us, but, like, it helps, it really does, but, like, we really don't need it. Like, we do it ourselves, like, personally, like, even in the summer, like, we had a new guys come over, and, like, it was just something that, like, especially, like, our captains and people that have been here longer than, like, a year or so, like, they knew, like, what it takes. Like, you can't just come in and play basketball with, like, no matter how good you are, you have to be, like, a unit at one to get to that, like you said, where we're trying to go.
Yeah, but like we get together, like everyone's there, like after practice, you know, who's on 2K, who's on Madden, who's on.
Or we just have everybody come over to somebody's house. And then
who's the best Madden player in the group?
I'll take that.
He won last time, so I guess he take that for right now.
Okay. Sure. And 2K, who's the best 2K player?
You play 2K?
All right, so you're from New Zealand. Talk about the transition of coming over from New Zealand. So New Zealand ball to ball in the state of Sac State.
The transition, it wasn't too bad. Probably the hardest thing was moving away from my family. Being 13-hour flight. It's not easy to just go home now and then, so I only get to see them like six weeks out of the year. And it's not too bad, I'm used to it now, but when I first came in as a freshman, I was a little homesick at the start, but then everyone here like welcomed me, so it was basically like another home to me. And just the basketball side of things, it was kind of similar, you know, just physical, fast-paced, and everything else was pretty smooth.
Okay, New Zealand. You guys have the Hawker there. You taught your teammates how to,
No, I never taught them. Well, I only told one person, but that's because he had to do it for initiation.
Okay.
But,
and you guys interested in learning the haka?
I'm for sure, definitely. I'm
always so interested.
I'm for sure.
I played in college with a guy from New Zealand, and he didn't teach us the haka. Talked about it a lot, and then until YouTube, you know, came along 20 years later, and I saw what it was all about, it's kind of impressive. You guys have seen it, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I think that'd be kind of intimidating, you guys. Yeah.
I think Vase would do it.
Break that out in the big sky.
That's not
your thing. So what is your thing? Mm-hmm. Talking about this team. So this team, Coach Katz refers to you guys as a hard hat group. So you guys bring your lunch pail, get to work. And I'm after watching you guys practice today, I think that's, you know, that's pretty fitting. Mm-hmm. What do you guys feel about that?
I think that's true. But I would say off the court, just like Bryce was saying, like, you know, someone's gonna get on it. Like, you know, Captain's gonna get on one of us. Like, you know, at the end of the day, it's just basketball. But off the court, like, it's jokes. Like, you know, exactly. Everyone's laughing. Everyone's having fun. Everyone's trying to figure out what they're going to do afterwards. You know, people linking up. So it's literally, it's like I said earlier, it's literally like a brotherhood.
Okay.
So.
Yeah.
Okay.
For sure.
Talk to me about Coach Katz. What's it like playing for Coach Katz?
Okay.
Everyone's laughing and smiling. Yeah. Talk to me about it.
You got it.
I got it. Okay. You know, Coach Katz is somebody that cares about you a lot. He's going to be tough on you because he wants to pull out the best in you every day. So, you know, that's one of the reasons why I came here is because Coach Katz just seemed like a guy that really just wanted to help develop everybody that he was around, and he just genuinely cares about you.
Okay.
So, that's something, I know that means something to everybody that's in our program. And you know, there'll be some days that he'll just be on you and just be going off on you, but you know that he's just trying to pull out the best in you, so, you know.
He's unorthodox, okay. I would say that. Okay. I mean, especially like compared to the coaches I've had, he's different, but like, you know, like especially being around him, like me being like last year, having like getting used to it, like you could tell that like, okay, he knows what he's trying to get the point he's trying to get across.
Okay.
So like once you get over that, once you can like understand like the method behind the madness,
yeah,
then it's like, okay, like I get it now. Let me just follow what he's doing, and then,
okay,
because he's not gonna just stray you wrong or stray us wrong. So yeah.
Okay. You two are the captains of this group. Talk about that leadership and what it means to the rest of these guys to follow your example.
You know, just got to lead by example every day. The coaches are real hard on us to go and just make sure the group is ready every day to work hard. And, you know, we just try to just go out there and make sure everybody has the same mindset.
I would say the same thing, just kind of making sure everybody's on the same page, you know, and like that we're all, what we're all striving for. And
I mean, some days there's going to be some bad days where you got to constantly get on people to make sure that they're staying up to the level of the group, so we don't have anybody like bringing us down. So we're, because obviously like you're stronger than your weakest link, so we can't have anybody down. So we got to make sure we're picking everybody up. And some days you're going to have to like get on certain people, and that then, and that's what's great about this team. They understand that, and they don't take that like offensively. They don't take that personal. Hard. So
okay.
They know that we're just trying to help them get them better and make the team better.
You guys have some games on your schedule this year. Pac-12 versus Colorado. Talk to me about that. What are you guys expecting to run into?
I've been here the longest. I think Isaiah and CJ were here, yeah. Their freshman year when we played them up there. And to be honest, they just beat us down. So I know us old guys, we still have that in our head. So I'm not trying to let that happen this year. So we're just trying to work hard. So when we go up there this year, we can come out with a different outcome.
Awesome. UC Davis at the Golden One Center. What can we expect from that?
Those games are always like a kind of like just a straight battle. Like they're never really like the most fun games to watch because they're just kind of straight defensive, kind of who's going to be the kind of toughest of the game. So those aren't ever really like the prettiest games, but they're definitely fun to play because it's a grind to win those
Some
games.
Of the most fulfilling.
That's that Causeway game. So talk about that. How do you guys have that, you have that rivalry with Davis?
So and playing it at the Golden One just makes it that much better. Like that's the first time I've ever played on like a NBA court or like official court. So it was just crazy. Like going into the locker room, like you could just feel the energy as soon as we got there. And we got it last year, so we know like they're gonna be coming like 10 times harder just because you know they don't want to lose.
You got the game last year. Yeah. What was that feeling like? You guys get that double?
That was amazing.
Okay.
It was good because we had Al. Fans over here and their fans were all on the opposite side, and once we got that win,
it was just crazy. And we go back in the locker room and everybody like, okay. And then cats come in, yeah, it was hot.
You guys are considered the players to watch for Sac State this year. Why should people come watch you guys play?
I think you're very energizing, like fast paced. You got JP. You know, dunking everything. You got Zay shooting, lights out shooting. You got OC crafting, making moves. You got Bryce full up, you know, finishing. And you got, you know, Italian Stallion over here. You know, Bulldog. So.
Okay.
All right.
And we're gonna be fun to watch.
Okay.
We're gonna be fun to watch. We're gonna be, you'll be able to tell our chemistry by just watching how we play.
I think obviously we lost Marcus, which is a big deal, but I think just all of us were here last year and think that we just have that chemistry built that obviously it's a big loss, but I think we'll be able to make that up since we've played with each other for a whole year now. And I think even just as a team, like even like we're just fun to watch because even if like the people who aren't playing, they're up jumping, yelling, going crazy on the bench. So we always have constant energy going during the game.
Awesome. You touched on a great point, losing a guy like Marcus Graves. How do you guys fill that void?
I feel like we already filled it.
Okay.
So
I feel like everybody is aware of how important he was to the team.
Yeah.
So everybody is like, okay, everybody knows how much more we have to step up to fill.
We got guys that are coming in. I know Bryce and Isaiah are going to take more of that role. We also have Brandon Davis who's going to take a lot of that role that Marcus had. So we just have guys that just got to step up all around. And it's just a collective effort.
We have Marcus new guys. We have new guys that know they're like competing for a spot. So you know, even though they're freshmen or transfers or whatever, like they're also coming in like, okay, they had this guy who was like the guy. And now we have these two, like especially our point guards, like they have Zay and Didi, who like they get to learn under. And like also have to compete against, so it's just like a good dynamic where you're learning from the guys, you're playing with the guys, but you're also going against the guys at the same time. So that, like being able to be in that situation, I think it's helped everybody on the team, and it's also been able to push us to know like, okay, we're gonna have to take everything to like another level for like this year.
Awesome. What did you learn and take from Marcus playing with you guys over the past couple years?
I think I took a lot. I was with him for 3 years. Raised my sophomore year, but I think me and him together we've been through a lot with back surgeries, and I think that just collectively made us tighter. We did everything together, and then just basketball-wise, I learned a lot from him. Yeah. I was under his wing the whole time, and even to this day, I'm still learning from him, getting shots up with him, and just experience what he's trying to do now on the professional side of things, and see where it goes from there.
Awesome. Talk to me about that. So we're talking guys like Marcus Graves. A few years back, you guys had Cody Demps. What was it like playing with Cody Demps, and you guys see his, you know, ascent into the professional level? What's that mean to you guys?
That's something big. Cody was a senior when I was a freshman, my redshirt year. An amazing player. And just seeing the stuff that he's done right now is really inspiring, because I was a guy that was, he wasn't highly recruited, came to his hometown team, went on, and he's doing great things now. So, you know, like, I still talk to him every once in a while. But, you know, he's just really, really doing good for himself.
So you the only one that was here when Cody was here?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But also, like, saying that, just like I was saying earlier, like, it's a brotherhood. So, like, the alumni do a great job of coming back and hooping with us. So it might be Cody, it might be Mike, it might be Nick, Eric, Travis when he's back, you know, in the States. Just, like, any number of those guys coming back and hooping with us.
Okay.
Like, I never played with Cody, but I've worked out with him numerous amount of times for us to be, like, actually cool. And I can say that for all of us.
Okay.
Everyone's worked out with each one of those people, person to know that we're, like, good. So.
Right. That's part of the legacy of Sac State basketball. So before you guys probably were born, trying to think age group wise where you guys are at, but that's about the time Sac State turned Division I. They had a couple guys here, Sean Smart, Sean McClendon. They were one of the top Division II teams in the country. That's how you guys ended up in Division I. Their coach, Joey Anders, pretty special people. Talk about Big Sky play.
Tough.
Okay.
A lot of traveling.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is that the toughest part? Is it the travel, the grind of it?
Yeah.
You know, everybody knows each other once we get into conference play. Everybody's battling. There's really no blowouts. There might be one or two blowouts, but there's not many. So it's just a constant grind, just like what CJ said with the travel. And then just the demand on your body during games. So it's just
a long process.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. What's going to take each of you guys over the top this year? You guys lost a few close games last year that could have put you with a higher seeding going into the conference tournament. What's going to take to get you guys into that conference tournament where you're going deep into it and looking at an NCAA berth?
I think we just have to, like we had to learn from last year kind of and finish out those games. We had a lot of games where we just kind of, especially early on in conference, where we just didn't finish them out. We just didn't execute late. So I think just learning from that, and I mean, that can kind of change your whole mood going into it, especially when it's the start of conference. It'll give you a big confidence boost.
Yeah.
And I just think all the teams are kind of really similar. There's no one that's like, oh, they're going to win the league, like, no doubt.
Yeah.
So I think it's just a constant battle of being consistent every day. And just showing up every night, just giving it all you got, and executing all throughout the game, and just finishing out.
Okay.
I think again, like, taking care of our bodies. I feel like even the traveling, like, takes a toll on our bodies. So it was that, and like bruising, like, you know, by the end of the season, like, everything's hurt, everything's sore at least.
Oh yeah.
So it was just like us really taking advantage of like our therapy and going to the training room and doing all that too. Like you said, like, learning from last year. That was me personally. That's one thing that I, like, got from last year. Like, I wasn't taking full advantage of everything that I had here. So I feel like that'll be, like, something to get over the hump for us, too.
Last year, you guys lost 12 games on Saturday.
Yeah. I feel like that's more of a, just like Lance was saying, it's more of a consistency thing.
Yeah.
Like, you got to bring it every day. But, like, some games we didn't finish out.
Okay.
A lot of games we didn't finish out, especially on Saturdays, because we went on Thursday. We kind of let up, or we would start the game hard and then not finish it out. So it's more of just being consistent throughout that game, playing hard.
Yeah. What do you guys need to do? I mean, can you guys talk to Kath about changing the schedule? No games on Saturday. That's what I would have done.
Yeah, so, unfortunately, we don't have that much power.
All right, so we're going to play and we're going to win this year.
Just got to figure it out.
So this year the motto is a dub on Saturday.
Thursday and Saturday.
If it wasn't basketball, what sports would you guys be playing?
Rugby.
Rugby? Football?
Yeah. Soccer.
Soccer?
I honestly think I'd be playing baseball. Like, if I didn't live in Arizona, where it's way too hot, I probably would play baseball.
Okay.
I was pretty good, but I just couldn't play in the 100-degree weather.
Okay.
Volleyball?
Okay.
Yeah, I wouldn't be playing sports. I'd probably still just be playing my instrument, the trumpet that I used to play.
Okay. You'd be in the band.
Yeah. I really love it.
Yeah.
I'll probably be in the band, too.
I'll be a producer.
No, that would change.
After basketball, what's it going to be like for you guys? What are you hoping to do after you graduate?
Well, after I graduate, I'll play professional basketball back home in Australia.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm just trying to be able to play basketball.
After that? After professional?
After graduation.
Oh, after graduation.
Hey, you can take whatever. Take it as far as you want to take it.
Oh, my. Yeah. I'm after professional playing. I'm going to be a mogul.
Okay.
I'm going to have movies. I'm going to have record companies. Okay. I'm going to have movies. I'm going to have books. It's coming.
All right. Like it.
Oh, after I'm done playing basketball, after it's said and done, I honestly want to get into real estate, but I'm probably going to go to grad school afterwards, you know, get my master's after basketball said and done. So.
Okay. Well, for sure, start to play professionally in Italy or in Europe in general. Take advantage of that, and then probably try to open a business for my dad.
Okay.
Something Italian themed. Not sure yet, but something for sure.
Okay.
I would say just play basketball as long as I can, and then after that, just probably try to stay in the sports stuff. I really like watching like basketball and football.
Okay.
So just kind of staying on that, whether it's like being a sports analyst or being a coach or something like that.
Okay. Three seconds on the clock, down by two. Who gets the ball?
I think it's just still depends on hot hand, but I think if we need a three, if we're going for the win, I think we're going with Zay.
Are you guys the go for the win type of team, or is it tie it, take it to overtime?
I feel like it's the type of game. Like if it's a real like hard game, we just want to end it. Like we don't want to go to overtime, play extra minutes. We kind of just want to end it
because of the grind.
Yeah, it's just.
That's a good point. That's a good point. That's better. That's better. Okay, so they're giving you the ball. What do you think about that? They trust you. I love that. All right, I got one more question. What would it mean to this group to win the Big Sky tournament and take that NCAA berth?
That'd be everything.
I just think it'd be something like just historic because it's never been done. Yeah. So I just think knowing that we did something that no one else has ever done before is just
like
incredible.
Mike McKinney and them came up here and they was like talking with us about like how, because they went like the farthest that Sac State went. So he was just saying how when they got here, him and the other captain, Dylan, they were like, they wanted to do something that, you know, it's never been done. So we're like, we need to do something that's never been done. Like, that's our goal this year.
I'm so just trying to one
that'd be big.
Okay.
So top it off.
Getting that berth. What do you think? Can it happen?
It can happen.
We need to do.
Because like you said, you got to be consistent.
Okay. So it's playing big at the right time.
Yes, sir.
All right. Well, good luck this year, you guys. We really appreciate you guys coming out.
Thanks for
talking to the Sacramento basketball community about who you guys are. Bringing you guys closer as young student athletes, getting ready to do something special. All right. Wish you guys nothing but the best of luck.
Appreciate it.
That's the Sacramento Basketball Show. Today's guest again, the Sac State men's basketball team. We'll see you guys again next week with